Hi guys, in today's video we are going to be looking at how we can individually paste filter from one to multiple image in Adobe Photoshop. This is Twisted Creative. I like to manage my name. It's your first time on this channel. Please do me a favor. Do me a favor by hitting that subscribe button. Not only by hitting that subscribe button, also ring that notification bell so that you don't miss any of the next video. Without wasting much time, let's jump into it. This is the model we are going to be using. We have this other image of this pretty girl here. Then if you look at this, we have them. They are a kind of looking alike because it was shot in the same environment, the same place, the same aperture, speed, and ISO. So we are going to be adjusting by adding some of this filter in Camera Raw to this particular image now. Then what we're going to do, just go to Filter, go to Camera Raw. At least you and I know that we have some other filters that we can also add to images, but now we are going to be using Camera Raw. So we have Camera Raw open here. Then if you take a look at this image now, we have the exposure. It's like it's looking whitish. Then we have to correct the exposure by bringing it down a bit. Let's say minus 0.70 should be, let's say 0.70 should be okay. Then let's go to contrast and pull it up a bit, like let's say plus 15 or plus 31. Plus 31 is okay for the contrast. Then highlight. Let's pick the highlight up a little, and the whites can bring it down a little, like minus 16 will be okay for the whites. And the blacks, we have to bring it down also to like minus 35 should be okay, or minus 36. Let's say minus 35. There are lots and lots of adjustments we can make here, but we have to stop here for the sake of the tutorial. Let's just hit okay. Because if you take a look at this camera, we have a lot and lots and lots of things that can be done to this image. So let's just hit okay for now for this image. Then we'll have it like this. Then the purpose of this tutorial is that these settings that we made to this image, how can we take it to other images? That is just the purpose of this tutorial. So let's go by going to the next image. Now we are going to be creating a copy by using Ctrl J to create a copy. Ctrl J. So we have it copied. We have background layer and we have layer one. The reason why we created this copy is for us to see the before and after. Now we have one on top, which is layer one, which we are going to be adding this effect to. Now, how can we add this effect without going into Camera Raw to make this adjustment? It's just a simple keyboard shortcut, which is Ctrl Alt F. So if I hold my Ctrl down, I hold my Alt down, then I push my F down. It's loading. So here we have it. Let's just zoom in a bit, and this is it. Is it not amazing? Let's just see the before and after. Let's just put this guy off and see what is underneath. Isn't it amazing? So we have it like this. So immediately you can still go and paste it on the next image. Go to this image and use Ctrl J to duplicate it as usual. Then use your Ctrl Alt F to paste. So it's just a simple logic. It's just like copy and paste. But now we did not copy. Photoshop did that automatically. Then all you need to do to paste this thing is just for you to use your Ctrl Alt, then F. Hold your Ctrl down, your Alt down, and push your F down. You have it paste to the image. Isn't that amazing? It does not end there. You can still go to other images that you have, and like this is image from, as in another model somewhere else. And let me just say, If I should apply it to this image, it's still the same process. I still use my Control Alt F. Then you see, isn't that amazing? You can do anything to any image in Photoshop, but as long as you did not go to that filter, as long as you did not go to that filter, it will always remain there. You can bring in any picture, any image from any direction, from any part of your system, and you can even bring it from internet and open it there. It's going to open, and if you use Control Alt F, it's going to paste that the same camera raw filter that we used there. Isn't that amazing? But the only way it changes is when you go and maybe you go to image, you go to filter, then you go to blur, then you go to Gaussian blur. Maybe after making some adjustments on the blur, then your next pasting is going to be blur. And it's going to be that Gaussian blur that you used. Isn't that amazing? It's interesting. So I think it's a very simple concept which everybody can use. You can apply it in your workflow. It's going to make your workflow fast. That is it for today's video. If you find it interesting, helpful, and useful, please hit that like button. And also leave a comment below telling us where it has helped you, where it has not, and the area we need to improve on. Like I said earlier, if you are new on this channel, please do me a favor. Do me a favor by hitting that subscribe button. Not only by hitting that subscribe button, also ring that notification bell so that you don't miss any of the next video. And it's also going to help us in YouTube algorithm. Thanks for watching today's video. Creative people, keep on creating. Please stay creative. Bye for now. See you in the next video.